Now, I love the reminder that we hear in that song, the idea that everything is holy now. And I think that's one of those spiritual truths that we forget from time to time. We forget to look around us and see and be reminded of where the presence of God is in the world around us. And I think that's not really the only spiritual truth that we forget. I don't know about you, but I forget things from time to time. Have any of you ever forgotten anything? Anything that's some big things? It happened to a friend of mine just a few weeks ago. He just bought a brand new car, and he drove it off the lot, so he's very preoccupied with this new car and with getting his phone hooked up to it, and he's pushing the buttons and see what button does what. And so he's so preoccupied with it that he's driving down the road, and then all of a sudden he has that feeling come over him that he'd forgotten something. Has that ever happened to you? You kind of get that feeling, okay, what did I forget? The garage door was put down, I turned the coffee pot. So he had that kind of stuff running through his mind, and it got to the point where he actually pulled over to the side of the road, and he turned around and he counted his bags. He had all of his bags in the bags, and he felt his pockets, and everything was there. Okay, well, I must be all right. So he kept on driving, but it kept kind of bugging him. And it kept kind of like just needling back his head. So he checked again, and everything was there. And he pulled into his driveway, and his 5-year-old daughter ran out. And she looked at him and said, "Daddy, where's Mommy?" Okay, so thankfully I've never forgotten Sarah, left her behind, or left Harper behind anywhere. I can't imagine what would happen if I did that. I'm kind of getting the look from the family room right now. But we do. We forget those sorts of big things in our lives. We forget these spiritual truths that we know. We hear them when we come here on Sunday, and then somehow we forget what they are. And so today is a reminder of one of those spiritual truths. It's a reminder of what I consider to be the greatest truth. And that's a truth with this capital T. And that's something you'll hear from time to time in Unity. It's kind of a Unity speak sort of thing. We'll talk about this truth with a capital T. And what we're really saying is that it's something that's true of the spiritual realm of God. It's a divine truth. And so that's why it's got that capital T to it. But it's a truth that exists within us that comes from that presence of God. Our co-founder, Myrtle Fillmore, wrote quite a bit about these spiritual truths. And there's a wonderful story about Myrtle. She had a really remarkable life as she worked with her husband Charles to found what we know today as the Unity Movement. And if you want to know more about Myrtle, there's a wonderful book written about her. And it's called Torchbearer to Light the Way. And it's by Neil Valle. They actually have sold out of it in the bookstore, but they let me know that they will be more than happy to order it for you if you'd like to read more about Myrtle. But what I'd like to share with you today comes from her book, How to Let God Help You. And it's right in the first chapter. And it was one of those things where I read it and thought, well, if this is in the first chapter, the rest of this has to be really good. And it is. She writes, "When we use the word truth with a capital T, we mean that which is true of God and true of God's children. The spiritual truth is that you are God's own beloved child, and that God is ever giving you his own wisdom, love, power, life, and substance. The spiritual truth is that you are God's own beloved child, and that God is forever giving you his own wisdom, love, power, life, and substance. I would consider that to be the greatest spiritual truth that we can live by. If we can really get this idea that we are a divine child of God, if we can really live from that place where we know that as a divine child of God, we are forever getting the love, the light, the wisdom of God, well, then our life becomes transformed in the process. And you know, although I love the way that Myrtle words it here, this isn't really a new thought. This isn't a new idea that that we're a divine child of God, that we have this presence of God within us. In fact, we can find evidence of it throughout the entire scriptures. And in fact, that's why I look at it and say, this is the greatest spiritual truth that we can really take a hold of and learn from. And I think that's true of anything. If you can look throughout history, you find evidence of it in multiple different places and multiple different accounts. That's usually something that makes you want to go, oh, we should pay attention to what this is saying. And this idea of a divinity within you, of the presence of God working in, through, and around you, I said it's nothing new. We find evidence of it in the Hebrew scriptures. We find evidence of it in Genesis, where it says God made us in his own image and likeness. We're made in the image and likeness of God. You go ahead and look in the book of Exodus. You find all sorts of examples with the story of Moses. Times where Moses would say, I'm not strong enough to do this. And then he gets filled with the presence of God. Jump ahead to the Christian scriptures. You find evidence of Jesus saying, talking about the kingdom of heaven within you. And you find Paul writing about Christ in you being your hope of glory. There's this continual idea throughout the scriptures of this presence of God that moves in us and around us and through us. And so the way Myrtle was worded, it might be a little different than what the writers of the scriptures wrote thousands of years ago. But that core idea is still there. And it's that core idea that there's this presence within us, that we are forever connected to it. But that's the part we forget from time to time. That's the part that we need to remember. And once we remember that truth, that's how we truly begin to transform our lives. When we really live from that place of knowing that we are the divine presence of God, of knowing that presence moves through us, and as a child of that presence, we inherit the goodness of that presence. That's how we really begin to transform our lives. And as I looked at this, and as I looked on at what Myrtle had to say about it, she talked about three aspects of our life, three parts of our life that we really need to bring in harmony with God in order to fully realize this greatest truth. And so today we're going to take a look at those three aspects of our lives. And when I looked at this, I was like, well, yeah, I know that. But it was a nice reminder. Because I forgot that all three have to work together. That we can't neglect just one area of our life and expect to really transform ourselves in the way that we've been promised we can. So the first area of our life that we really need to grow and exercise in order to fully understand the power of God that we all are, it's our mind. We have to grow ourselves at a mental level. There's this phase in our life where we'll hear something new, a new spiritual idea, and then we want to spend time exploring that idea. You see, not every spiritual concept is going to work for every single one of us. There are some that work for me that don't work for others. In fact, Reverend Bob and I were talking just a few weeks ago. There are times where I'm up here and I'll say something and Bob will think that doesn't work for me. So it's different for every one of us. But we have to at least be willing to stretch ourselves, to grow ourselves, to explore new areas of spirituality. Otherwise, we kind of get stuck in that same place. So we commit to growing our mind. We commit to exploring and expanding our mind. And the way we do that is through taking classes, through enrolling in workshops with spiritual themes, through reading different books by various authors that have spiritual messages or ideals in them. And unity is considered positive, practical Christianity. And the reason for that is because we like to give you experiences of the things that we're talking about. And so every month, Reverend Jan puts together a list of classes that we're offering in the ministry. Things that you can do to begin to explore different concepts of spirituality. And every single one of those classes is listed right here in this bulletin. So look through this. Look at what we have coming up. I'm looking here, that it's just on the first page. We have a class about chanting and singing. Well, we already had a class about chanting and singing in prayer. It was on August 4th, so got a little early in the month. But we have some classes coming up about Unity Basics, classes coming up about our community, classes that can help you begin to explore new spiritual ideals. These are also listed on our Facebook page. If you don't like us on Facebook and you don't look at our Facebook page, look at it and see. There's wonderful stuff that's coming up here at this ministry. And when you attend one of these classes, what might happen is you'll hear somebody say something and your heart will just kind of hum a little bit. Wait a minute. I like the way that sounded. Pay attention to those. Because that's that voice of God within you saying, explore this idea more. This might have something to do with your expression of God. And then once you've kind of explored that a little bit more, you're going to take it into the next step of our soul's growth. See, the next thing we need to be growing and exercising is our spirit. We're growing our mind through attending classes and workshops and learning new things about the presence of God. And then we grow our spirit through prayer and meditation. And I know we've talked about prayer and meditation before, so I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time on how to meditate, how to pray, that sort of thing. If you are curious about that, you can go onto our website and look through our past lessons. On Father's Day of this year, we talked about how to meditate. And most all of our lessons are posted on our website, so you can stroll down memory lane and remember fondly all the wonderful Sundays we've had here. But prayer and meditation is a key to really growing and expanding your spiritual side. And there are a couple of reasons why it works this way. The first is that it's a reminder. It serves as a reminder of the truth of God that you are. When you take that time to go into prayer and go into meditation and connect with God, it reminds you that you are the presence of God. The other thing that it allows you to do is to take any of those ideas, those things you heard about in a class or you read about in a book, it allows you to take those in within you to the presence of God and to check in with God and see, is this a practice that has any meaning for me in my life? Sometimes the answer might be no. But it allows you to check in with that. So even if you're sitting there saying, I don't have time to pray, I get it, you keep telling me to pray, I don't have time to pray. I know Reverend Bob and I, or Bob would join with me in saying piffle to that, wouldn't you, Bob? Yes, piffle. There is always enough time for prayer. Even if your prayer is just, dear God, I've been pretty good so far today. I haven't lied, I haven't cheated, I haven't been selfish, I've been pretty peaceful, I haven't gotten angry with anybody or snapped at anybody. But God, in a few moments I'm going to get out of bed. And I know from that point on I'm going to need lots of help. Thank you, God, amen. Even if that's your prayer, take that time to acknowledge that that presence of God is there. Take that time to meditate. The simple truth is that we grow ourselves spiritually. We grow in our spirit through prayer and meditation. And it takes more than 5 to 7 minutes on a Sunday morning to be able to do that. So commit to a daily practice of prayer and meditation. Commit to checking in with the new ideas that you're learning. And begin to grow your mind and your spirit. All right, so where are we so far? So far, we've talked about the importance of growing our mind and our connection to God through taking classes, through taking workshops, through reading spiritual concepts and books and web pages. And we've talked about growing our spirit through having a daily meditation practice, a daily prayer and meditation practice. And both of these practices, what they do is they bring your mind and your spirit into harmony with the presence of God. And there's one more. There's one more aspect that we really need to be paying attention to, and I saved it for last because it's the one I forget the most often, and that's our body. That's that we should really be growing and strengthening our body, strengthening our awareness of our body, strengthening an awareness of what we can do for our body to make sure that it's operating to the best of its capabilities. You know, it's really hard to focus on God when your body is breaking down around you. It's really easy to get distracted if you're in pain or if you're just not feeling real healthy. And so that's the third thing that we need to pay attention to. We need to grow and learn and exercise our body. Now, I'm not just talking strictly about healthy living and waking up and running 5 miles every day, because if that's the case, I know I would have issue with that. And I had a couple of people after the first service that said, I'm glad you didn't tell us that running 5 miles every day was a spiritual practice. It can be for you, but I think the most important thing to do with the health of our body is to check in with ourselves. You know, there's a lot of information out there about what works, what we should do, what we shouldn't do, eat this, don't eat that. And we need to pay attention to that, but we go back to that meditation step. And we take those things that we learn, those things that we hear, go into meditation. And then based off of your own reason, your own intellectual understanding, and how that presence of God guides you, let it guide you in making choices that are maybe more healthy than others. Now, also be careful with this. It's real easy to beat ourselves up. You know, and to sit there like I did last night and go, okay, really should have got that salad instead of the double bacon cheeseburger, but the double bacon cheeseburger is really good. You know, this isn't about doing things to shame ourselves or to think, oh, I should have done this. It's about making an effort to make those choices that allow our body to function in a way that allows us to really grow and expand that presence of God within us. You see, never forget the truth that we are ultimately spiritual beings. We're having a human, a physical experience. And this body is how we interact with the world around us. In fact, it's the front line. So it's the thing that gets those messages, those reinforcing statements that we're separate, or that we're alone and we don't have the presence of God with us, or that we're not enough, or that we won't be enough unless we have this certain thing. And so if we can affirm our own health, our own wellness, the truth of the matter, that we're divine, it helps limit that reinforcement that you're separate. And as always, check in with yourself. When you're watching the evening news and you hear something on the news about something you should be doing or eating or not eating, or you're scrolling through Facebook and you're seeing a list of what you can and can't eat now and what's good for you and what's not good for you, check in with yourself with those things. In your meditation time, just ask, what's the best for me to do right now? And listen to the presence of God. See, the greatest spiritual truth is that you, each and every one of you, myself included, are divine. You're the presence of God right here, right where you are. Expressing that divine presence is our role now. So the best way to do that is to grow our mind, to grow our spirit, to grow our body. And it's through growing these things that we remember the truth ultimately in all circumstances that you are a divine child of God. You are the sacred light of God. And so we commit to working with these practices, working with these principles, and shining our light brightly in this community, in this world. And so go shine your lights. God bless you.